Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Dutch ebook before it's gone.
Hi everyone, I'm Gabriella. How are your Dutch listening skills? In this video, you'll have a chance to test them out with a quiz. First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Een vrouw vraagt een winkelbediende iets in een boekenwinkel. Welk boek wilt de vrouw zien? Ik wil graag een boek van die plank bekijken.
Welk boek wilt u?
Die ene over auto's.
Momentje, alstublieft. Deze?
Ja, die.
Alstublieft.
Welk boek wilt de vrouw zien? Een vrouw vraagt een winkelbediende iets in een boekenwinkel. Welk boek wilt de vrouw zien? Ik wil graag een boek van die plank bekijken.
Welk boek wilt u?
Die ene over auto's.
Momentje, alstublieft. Deze?
Ja, die.
Alstublieft.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Dutch listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Een man en een vrouw kijken naar een menu in een restaurant. Wat gaat de man bestellen?
Wat ga je bestellen?
Die pizza ziet er lekker uit. Ik denk dat ik die kies.
Ik had gisteren pizza, dus...
Oké, en hoe denk je over een hamburger?
Klinkt goed. Ja, die dan maar.
Wat gaat de man bestellen? Een man en een vrouw kijken naar een menu in een restaurant. Wat gaat de man bestellen?
Wat ga je bestellen?
Die pizza ziet er lekker uit. Ik denk dat ik die kies.
Ik had gisteren pizza, dus...
Oké, en hoe denk je over een hamburger?
Klinkt goed. Ja, die dan maar.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Dutch listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Een man belt naar de praktijk van een dokter. Hoe laat moet hij bij de praktijk van de dokter zijn? Hallo, wat kan ik voor u doen?
Hoe laat sluit u vandaag?
Wij sluiten om 6 uur, maar kom alstublieft om 5:30.
Oké, dank u wel.
Hoe laat moet hij bij de praktijk van de dokter zijn? Een man belt naar de praktijk van een dokter. Hoe laat moet hij bij de praktijk van de dokter zijn? Hallo, wat kan ik voor u doen?
Hoe laat sluit u vandaag?
Wij sluiten om 6:00, maar kom alstublieft om 5:30.
Oké, dank u wel.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Dutch listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Een jongen leest zijn dagboek. Wat was het eerste wat de jongen vandaag deed?
Het weer was prachtig vandaag. Ik ben vanmiddag wezen zwemmen in het zwembad. En 's avonds ben ik naar de film geweest. Ik heb de hele ochtend gestudeerd. Vandaag viel heus wel mee.
Wat was het eerste wat de jongen vandaag deed? Een jongen leest zijn dagboek. Wat was het eerste wat de jongen vandaag deed?
Het weer was prachtig vandaag. Ik ben vanmiddag wezen zwemmen in het zwembad. En 's avonds ben ik naar de film geweest. Ik heb de hele ochtend gestudeerd. Vandaag viel heus wel mee.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time. How are your Dutch listening skills? First, you'll see an image and hear a question. Next comes a short dialogue. Listen carefully and see if you can answer correctly. We'll show you the answer at the end. Are you ready?
Een vrouw en een man kijken naar een foto. Naar welke foto kijken zij? Dit is toch een foto van een voetbalteam van je zoon? Welke is uw zoon?
Deze.
Oh, hij is de langste.
Ja, hij is nog langer dan ik.
Naar welke foto kijken zij? Een vrouw en een man kijken naar een foto. Naar welke foto kijken zij? Dit is toch een foto van een voetbalteam van je zoon? Welke is uw zoon?
Deze.
Oh, hij is de langste.
Ja, hij is nog langer dan ik.
Did you get it right? I hope you learned something from this quiz. Let us know if you have any questions. See you next time.
Ik heet Marleen. Hi everybody, I'm Marleen. Welcome to DutchBot101.com's Nederlands in 3 minuten. The fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Dutch. Hallo, ik heet Marleen. Leuk je te ontmoeten. Hi, I'm Marleen. Nice to meet you. In this series, we're going to learn basic Dutch expressions. It's super easy and it only takes 3 minutes. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to introduce yourself in Dutch. We'll start speaking right away, but first it's important to clarify that in Dutch, there's a difference between the formal and the informal language. Let's first see how Dutch people introduce themselves in an informal situation. Hallo, ik heet Marleen. Leuk je te ontmoeten. Hi, I'm Marleen. Nice to meet you. Hallo, ik heet Marleen. Leuk je te ontmoeten. Start by saying, hallo, ik heet. Then say your name. Hallo, ik heet Marleen. Finally, say, leuk je te ontmoeten. Hallo, ik heet Marleen. Leuk je te ontmoeten. And now, let's see the same sentence in formal speech. Goedendag, ik heet Marleen van den Berg. Aangenaam. Good day, I'm Marleen van den Berg. Pleasure to meet you. Goedendag, ik heet Marleen van den Berg. Aangenaam. So, what has changed from the previous introduction? Let's take a close look at these expressions together. Hallo has been substituted with the formal greeting Goedendag, which is Dutch for good day. Ik heet Marleen has not been changed. Ik heet simply means I am called. However, during a formal self-introduction, we also say our last name. So I said Marleen van den Berg. Here you would say your full name. One more time. The informal way to introduce yourself in Dutch is Hallo, ik heet Marleen. Leuk je te ontmoeten. The formal way to introduce yourself is Goedendag, ik heet Marleen van den Berg. Aangenaam. Now it's time for Marleen's insights. When you introduce yourself, it's a good habit to shake hands. If you are not sure whether to use Leuk je te ontmoeten or Aangenaam, just say simply Aangenaam, as this expression can be used in both the formal and informal introduction. If you use the correct sentence with Dutch people, they're definitely going to be impressed. That's it for this lesson. Do you know how we say thank you in Dutch? You'll learn how to say this and many other words in the next Nederlands in 3 minuten lesson. Tot ziens! Hallo allemaal, ik heet Marleen. Hi everybody, I'm Marleen. Welcome to DutchPod101.com's Nederlands in 3 minuten. The fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Dutch. In the previous lesson, we learned how to introduce ourselves in Dutch. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to use good manners as we thank people. Ben je er klaar voor? Are you ready? Let's start. There are several ways to thank someone. Let's start with the easiest. It's just one word. Bedankt. Bedankt. Bedankt means thank you. When saying thank you very much, you just need to add zeer at the beginning. Zeer bedankt. Zeer means a lot. So zeer bedankt is like saying thank you very much. During the last lesson, we discussed the informal and the formal way of speaking Dutch. Bedankt is the casual way to thank someone. If you want to be more formal, there's another phrase you should use. Dank u wel. Dank u wel. Let's break this phrase down. Dank is thank, and u is a formal word for you. We will discuss Dutch pronouns in more depth in a later lesson. Finally, wel means a lot. The full sentence once again is dank u wel. Actually, there's also an informal form of the expression dank u wel. In an informal setting, the correct expression is dank u wel. Dank je wel. The u from the expression dank u wel is simply replaced by je. Je is the informal word for you. How do you answer? It's easy. Here's the most common response. Graag gedaan. Graag gedaan. Graag gedaan can be used with just about anybody. Literally, this phrase means happily done or I did it with pleasure. So when someone is saying bedankt to you, we can simply reply with graag gedaan. Now it's time for Marleen's insights. If you're not sure about whether to use bedankt, dank u wel or dank je wel, keeping it simple is always your safest bet. You don't have to worry about formal or informal situations. Bedankt can be used with just about anyone, anywhere and at any time. Do you know what tot ziens means? In our next lesson, you'll learn this and other greetings in Dutch. Tot ziens! Hallo allemaal, ik heet Marleen. Hi everybody, I'm Marleen. Welcome to DutchPod101.com's Nederlands in 3 minuten. the fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Dutch. In the last lesson, we learned how to be grateful to people by saying bedankt. In this lesson, we'll learn some of the most common greetings used in Holland. Ben je er klaar voor? Are you ready? Let's start. The most used informal greeting is hallo. Hallo. Hallo means hi or hello. We should only use this greeting with friends or relatives. The most used formal greetings will change depending on the time of the day. Let's start with goedendag. Goedendag. Literally, goedendag means good day. As a rule of thumb, we can use goedendag only during the daytime, from late morning until early evening. In the morning we say goedemorgen, good morning. Goedemorgen. During the evening we say goedenavond, goedenavond. Goed is Dutch for good. Dag, morgen and avond means day, morning and evening, respectively. Easy, right? What should you say when you leave? Dutch people usually say tot ziens when leaving in a formal situation. Tot ziens. Tot ziens means goodbye. If we say goodbye to friends or our relatives, we use the informal word dag. Dag. You can also say doei. The expression doei is commonly used in informal situations. Doei. Now you can greet people in many different ways in Dutch. Let's review them all again. First, the greetings. Informally, we simply say hallo. Formally, use goedemorgen in the morning, goedendag in the afternoon, and goedenavond in the evening. When leaving in a formal situation, we say tot ziens, and in an informal situation, it's dag or doei. It's easy, isn't it? Now it's time for Marleen's insights. In formal situations, Dutch people commonly greet each other by shaking hands. On the other hand, if we meet someone we are very friendly with, we kiss each other on both cheeks, usually two or three times. Don't be afraid to do it with your Dutch friends. It's normal. During the next lesson, we'll learn the meaning of the phrase "Spreekt u Engels?" Do you already know it? I'll be waiting to talk about it with you in our next Nederlands in 3 minuten lesson. Tot ziens! Hallo allemaal, ik heet Marleen. Hi everybody, I'm Marleen. Welcome to DutchPod101.com's Nederlands in 3 minuten. The fastest, easiest, and most fun way to learn Dutch. In the previous lesson, we learned the most common forms of greetings in Dutch. Do you remember them? In this lesson, we're going to learn a very useful phrase. Do you speak English? If you find yourself in a situation where you need assistance in English, this phrase can be a lifesaver. And because you're asking it in Dutch, you can be sure that everyone will understand what you're saying, even if their answer is no. Here's the informal way to say it. Spreek je Engels? Spreek je Engels? In Dutch, verbs change depending on the pronoun that is used. Please notice the word je in the middle of the sentence. Remember that this is the informal way to say you. The first word is the verb spreek, which means to speak. Because it is referring to je, it is conjugated to spreek je. And you probably recognize Engels to be English. Spreek je Engels? To learn how to use different verbs, like spreken, please look at our Absolute Beginner series on DutchPod101.com. You can find very detailed grammar lessons and resources there. We're now going to make this sentence formal. First, we need to use the formal version of you, which is u. If we change the word for you, we will say the verb differently. It becomes spreekt instead of spreek, like in the informal version. Spreekt u Engels? Spreekt u Engels? Adding pardon, excuse me, the sentence becomes even more polite. Pardon, spreekt u Engels? Pardon, spreekt u Engels? The responses you will receive could be one of these three. Ja, yes, ja. Een beetje, a little. Een beetje. Nee, ik spreek geen Engels. No, I don't speak English. Nee, ik spreek geen Engels. Since the last one is a negative statement, we need to say geen after the verb spreken. Notice also that the verb spreek is slightly different than spreken. Remember, the verb changes depending on the pronoun used. We are now talking about ik, Dutch for I. Thus, I do not speak is ik spreek geen. Now it's time for Marleen's insights. For those of you who are not only English speakers, you can obviously use this question with any language you need. Dutch people study other European languages at school, so maybe you will get lucky. Just substitute Engels with Italiaans for Italian, Duits for German, Spaans for Spanish, Frans for French. In this lesson, we mentioned the expression pardon. But did you know that this could also be used as an apology? In the next lesson, we will learn this and other ways to apologize in Dutch. It's never too late to show your good manners with Dutch people. I'll see you in our next Nederlands in 3 minuten lesson. Tot ziens! Hallo allemaal, ik heet Marleen. Hi everybody, I'm Marleen. Welcome to DutchPod101.com's Nederlands in 3 minuten. The fastest, easiest and most fun way to learn Dutch. In the last lesson, we learned the phrase pardon, spreekt u Engels? Excuse me, do you speak English? We mentioned the word pardon, which means excuse me in formal Dutch. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to use pardon and other words when apologizing in Dutch. We should use pardon in formal situations, such as when we are ordering something in bars or restaurants. For example, pardon, een koffie alstublieft. Excuse me, a coffee please. We can also use it when asking a question. Pardon, waar is de uitgang? Excuse me, where is the exit? Pardon can also be a formal way to get someone's attention. Another phrase that can be used to get somebody's attention in a formal manner is excuseer. Excuseer. The informal way to say excuse me is sorry. Sorry. Just like pardon or excuseer, we can use sorry when asking a question or when apologizing. All of these phrases can be used for either excuse me or I'm sorry. But if you really want to apologize for something, it might be better to use a different phrase. That phrase is het spijt me. It means I am sorry and can be used in both formal and informal situations. Het spijt me. Let's take a closer look at this expression. First we have het or it. Next we insert the Dutch word for regret. Spijt. Me means me. Het spijt me. Now it's time for Marleen's insights. Please remember that in Holland, if we accidentally bump into someone, we don't say, I'm sorry, het spijt me. Instead we say, pardon, excuseer or sorry. Are you able to count in Dutch? In the next lesson, we will learn the numbers in Dutch from 1 to 10. I'll be waiting for you in our next Nederlands in 3 minuten lesson. Tot ziens!
Are you struggling to understand conversations in your target language? This video will improve your listening skills using practice dialogues. How do you know if your language skills are improving? Our team of teachers have designed a free quiz to determine your actual learning level. So click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for you. In this lesson, you'll listen to a dialogue with the text. Second, you'll review the key vocabulary followed by the English translations. And finally, you'll review the dialogue with the text again to master what you learned. first, listen to the dialogue with the text on the screen.
Goedemorgen, meneer. Hoe kan ik u helpen?
Goedemorgen. Ik wil graag wat geld wisselen.
Zeker, meneer. Welke valuta?
Dollars, contant of traveler checks. Welke koers is beter?
Ik raad u aan om een cheque te gebruiken, meneer.
Dank u wel voor het advies. $200 dan graag.
Jawel, meneer. Een ogenblikje, alstublieft.
Now you'll hear the key vocabulary, followed by the English translation.
Meneer.
Sir. Mister.
Meneer. Meneer. Helpen.
To help.
Helpen. Helpen. Wisselen.
To change. Money. To change. To break.
Wisselen. Wisselen. Contant.
Cash.
Contant. Contant. Koers.
Rate.
Koers. Koers. Gebruiken.
To use.
Gebruiken. Gebruiken. Advies.
Advice.
Advies. Advies. Ogenblikje.
Moment.
Ogenblikje. Ogenblikje.
Finally, let's review the dialogue again. See if you can understand more this time.
Goedemorgen, meneer. Hoe kan ik u helpen?
Goedemorgen. Ik wil graag wat geld wisselen.
Zeker, meneer. Welke valuta?
Dollars, contant of traveler checks. Welke koers is beter?
Ik raad u aan om een cheque te gebruiken, meneer.
Dank u wel voor het advies. $200 dan graag.
Jawel, meneer. Een ogenblikje, alstublieft.
This is the end of the lesson. In this lesson, you improved your listening and mastered key vocabulary for everyday life conversation. Don't forget to click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for your learning level. Keep practicing and move on to the next lesson. Are you struggling to understand conversations in your target language? This video will improve your listening skills using practice dialogues. How do you know if your language skills are improving? Our team of teachers have designed a free quiz to determine your actual learning level. So click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for you. In this lesson, you'll listen to a dialogue with the text. Second, you'll review the key vocabulary followed by the English translations. And finally, you'll review the dialogue with the text again to master what you learned. First, listen to the dialogue with the text on the screen.
Dames en heren, door een technische storing vertrekt vlucht KL214 vanaf gate 24 om 16:20.
Hey. Dat is onze vlucht. Wat zeiden ze?
De vlucht vertrekt van een andere gate. Gate 24.
Ja, 24 heb ik begrepen. Maar daarna begreep ik het niet.
Hij zei 16:20. Op een luchthaven zeggen ze niet 4:00 's middags, maar 16:00.
En die 20 betekent 20 minuten over 4.
Heel goed. Dan hebben we dus nog tijd voor een kop koffie.
Now you'll hear the key vocabulary, followed by the English translation.
Omroeper.
Announcer.
Omroeper. Omroeper. Storing.
Failure. Malfunction.
Storing. Storing. Vertrekken.
To leave. To depart.
Vertrekken. Vertrekken. Vlucht.
Flight.
Vlucht. Vlucht. 24.
24.
24. 24. Begrepen.
Understood.
Begrepen. Begrepen. Betekent.
Means.
Betekent. Betekent. Tijd.
Time.
Tijd. Tijd.
Finally, let's review the dialogue again. See if you can understand more this time.
Dames en heren, door een technische storing vertrekt vlucht KL214 vanaf gate 24 om 16:20.
Hey, dat is onze vlucht. Wat zeiden ze?
De vlucht vertrekt van een andere gate, gate 24.
Ja, 24 heb ik begrepen. Maar daarna begreep ik het niet.
Hij zei 16:20. Op een luchthaven zeggen ze niet 4:00 's middags, maar 16:00.
En die 20 betekent 20 minuten over 4.
Heel goed. Dan hebben we dus nog tijd voor een kop koffie.
This is the end of the lesson. In this lesson, you improved your listening and mastered key vocabulary for everyday life conversation. Don't forget to click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for your learning level. Keep practicing and move on to the next lesson. Are you struggling to understand conversations in your target language? This video will improve your listening skills using practice dialogues. How do you know if your language skills are improving? Our team of teachers have designed a free quiz to determine your actual learning level. So click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for you. In this lesson, you'll listen to a dialogue with the text. Second, you'll review the key vocabulary followed by the English translations. And finally, you'll review the dialogue with the text again to master what you learned. First, listen to the dialogue with the text on the screen.
Ik wil een mooie trui kopen.
Dan moet je naar de HEMA gaan. Die hebben aanbiedingen.
Goed idee. Ga je mee?
Kijk, deze is €50, maar met 30% korting.
Hoeveel zou dat dan worden?
Nou, €35.
Ja, natuurlijk. Welke kleur vind jij leuk?
Now you'll hear the key vocabulary, followed by the English translation.
Trui.
Sweater.
Trui. Trui. Kopen.
To buy.
Kopen. Kopen. Aanbieding.
Special offer.
Aanbieding. Aanbieding. Idee.
Idea.
Idee. Idee. Korting.
Reduction.
Korting. Korting. Kleur.
Color.
Kleur. Kleur.
Finally, let's review the dialogue again. See if you can understand more this time.
Ik wil een mooie trui kopen.
Dan moet je naar de HEMA gaan. Die hebben aanbiedingen.
Goed idee. Ga je mee?
Kijk, deze is 50 euro, maar met 30% korting.
Hoeveel zou dat dan worden?
Nou, 35 euro.
Ja, natuurlijk. Welke kleur vind jij leuk?
This is the end of the lesson. In this lesson, you improved your listening and mastered key vocabulary for everyday life conversation. Don't forget to click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for your learning level. Keep practicing and move on to the next lesson. Are you struggling to understand conversations in your target language? This video will improve your listening skills using practice dialogues. How do you know if your language skills are improving? Our team of teachers have designed a free quiz to determine your actual learning level. So click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for you. In this lesson, you'll listen to a dialogue with the text. Second, you'll review the key vocabulary followed by the English translations. And finally, you'll review the dialogue with the text again to master what you learned. First, listen to the dialogue with the text on the screen.
Hallo, dit is het antwoordapparaat van Bruno. Ik kan de telefoon nu niet opnemen, maar u kunt na de piep een bericht achterlaten.
Hoi Bruno, met Anna. Ik wil je even spreken. Kun je me terugbellen? Mijn nummer is 06-936-5657.
Now you'll hear the key vocabulary, followed by the English translation.
Bericht.
Message.
Bericht. Bericht. Antwoordapparaat.
Answering machine.
Antwoordapparaat. Antwoordapparaat. Telefoon.
Phone.
Telefoon. Telefoon. Opnemen.
To pick up.
Opnemen. Opnemen. Piep.
Piep.
Piep. Piep. Achterlaten.
To leave.
Achterlaten. Achterlaten. Spreken.
To speak.
Spreken. Spreken. Terugbellen.
To call back.
Terugbellen. Terugbellen. Nummer.
Number.
Nummer. Nummer.
Finally, let's review the dialogue again. See if you can understand more this time.
Hallo, dit is het antwoordapparaat van Bruno. Ik kan de telefoon nu niet opnemen, maar u kunt na de piep een bericht achterlaten.
Hoi Bruno, met Anna. Ik wil je even spreken. Kun je me terugbellen? Mijn nummer is 06-936-5657.
This is the end of the lesson. In this lesson, you improved your listening and mastered key vocabulary for everyday life conversation. Don't forget to click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for your learning level. Keep practicing and move on to the next lesson. Are you struggling to understand conversations in your target language? This video will improve your listening skills using practice dialogues. How do you know if your language skills are improving? Our team of teachers have designed a free quiz to determine your actual learning level. So click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for you. In this lesson, you'll listen to a dialogue with the text. Second, you'll review the key vocabulary followed by the English translations. And finally, you'll review the dialogue with the text again to master what you learned. First, listen to the dialogue with the text on the screen.
Anna, dit is mijn moeder. Mama, dit is Anna uit Amerika.
Hoe maakt u het, mevrouw? Aangenaam kennis te maken.
Dag Anna, leuk je te ontmoeten. Welkom in Holland.
En dit is mijn jonge zusje, Tineke.
Hoi, leuk je te zien. Anna heeft veel over je verteld.
Hallo, ik heet Tineke. Hoe gaat het met je?
Now you'll hear the key vocabulary, followed by the English translation.
Moeder.
Mother.
Uit.
From.
Ontmoeten.
To meet.
Aangenaam.
Pleasant.
Kennis maken.
Be introduced. To meet.
Jongen.
Young.
Zusje.
Little sister.
Verteld.
Told.
Hoe.
How.
Finally, let's review the dialogue again. See if you can understand more this time.
Anna, dit is mijn moeder. Mama, dit is Anna uit Amerika.
Hoe maakt u het, mevrouw? Aangenaam kennis te maken.
Dag Anna, leuk je te ontmoeten. Welkom in Holland.
En dit is mijn jonge zusje, Tineke.
Hoi, leuk je te zien. Anna heeft veel over je verteld.
Hallo, ik heet Tineke. Hoe gaat het met je?
This is the end of the lesson. In this lesson, you improved your listening and mastered key vocabulary for everyday life conversation. Don't forget to click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for your learning level. Keep practicing and move on to the next lesson. Are you struggling to understand conversations in your target language? This video will improve your listening skills using practice dialogues. How do you know if your language skills are improving? Our team of teachers have designed a free quiz to determine your actual learning level. So click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for you. In this lesson, you'll listen to a dialogue with the text. Second, you'll review the key vocabulary followed by the English translations. And finally, you'll review the dialogue with the text again to master what you learned. First, listen to the dialogue with the text on the screen.
Leuk je te ontmoeten, Peter. Waar kom je vandaan?
Ik ben in Canada geboren, maar in Amerika opgegroeid. Dus ik ben eigenlijk Amerikaans.
En waarom ben je naar Holland gekomen?
Ik studeer Nederlands en wil hier 2 jaar studeren, maar ook de hele dag de taal praten.
Een goed idee. En wat wil je later doen?
Ik wil tolk worden. Het liefst bij de Verenigde Naties.
Ik wens je veel sterkte.
Now you'll hear the key vocabulary, followed by the English translation.
Waar?
Where?
Opgegroeid.
Grown up.
Eigenlijk.
Actually.
Waarom?
Why?
Studeer.
Study.
Praten.
To talk.
Tolk.
Interpreter.
Sterkte.
Strength.
Finally, let's review the dialogue again. See if you can understand more this time.
Anna,
Leuk je te ontmoeten, Peter. Waar kom je vandaan?
Ik ben in Canada geboren, maar in Amerika opgegroeid. Dus ik ben eigenlijk Amerikaans.
En waarom ben je naar Holland gekomen?
Ik studeer Nederlands en wil hier 2 jaar studeren, maar ook de hele dag de taal praten.
Een goed idee. En wat wil je later doen?
Ik wil tolk worden, het liefst bij de Verenigde Naties.
Ik wens je veel sterkte.
This is the end of the lesson. In this lesson, you improved your listening and mastered key vocabulary for everyday life conversation. Don't forget to click the link in the description to get your free assessment and unlock lessons that are right for your learning level. Keep practicing and move on to the next lesson.
Most people who learn a foreign language learn it so that they can one day have real-life conversations with native speakers. When you start out learning and crack open your first textbook or listen to your first podcast, having a real conversation can feel like a fantasy. When everything about a language feels new, it can be overwhelming. But this couldn't be further from the truth. While it does take a significant amount of time and effort to become fluent, having a conversation might not be as far off as you think. In this video, we'll look at 3 ways you can boost your conversational skills and start talking to native speakers. Number 1, find native speakers and practice with them. It's unlikely you live near a big group of native speakers to practice with. If you happen to be in a major or international city, your chances may be better. Check and see if your city has a general language exchange. Chances are there could be a native speaker there who is also trying to learn another language. Practicing in person with a native speaker is probably the most interesting option for honing your speaking skills. But if you can't find anyone where you live, the next best option is to look online. Luckily for language learners, the past 10 years or so have seen an explosion in online language exchange sites. On these websites, you can search for someone who is a native speaker of your target language and is also learning your native language. The idea behind a language exchange is that you communicate with them via video or text chat, and half of the time, they help you practice your target language, and for the other half, you help them practice theirs. Practicing via an online language exchange is a highly effective way to practice your conversational skills. Number 2, work on pronunciation. Pronunciation is often an overlooked skill when it comes to learning a foreign language. Most people think of a good foreign accent as a luxury rather than a necessity. But what most people don't talk about is how having a good accent boosts your listening and comprehension skills. If you can hear a sound from a foreign language and know how to make it yourself, then you're more likely to understand native speakers when they talk at normal speed, and you're also more likely to remember any new words or phrases you come across. Having a good accent means that the language no longer sounds foreign. Instead, it sounds familiar, maybe even natural. So, how do you go about perfecting your accent? The best way is to break down the language into its individual sounds. Make note of any sounds that are the same or similar to your native language and of those that are different. Of the sounds that are different, spend your time practicing the ones that you find the hardest to say correctly. After you're comfortable with the individual sounds, you can start linking together words and phrases. This is where accent practice starts to get really fun and interesting. Get your hands on some native speaker audio from a TV show, song, or podcast. Play the audio back and listen closely a few times. Take note of how words blend together in speech. Then, do your best to imitate what you hear, trying to match the speaker's emphasis and intonation. Our language learning program's playback feature is perfect for this. Record yourself and compare it to the original recording. Rinse and repeat until you're comfortable with the audio selection, and then move on to something more difficult. This is how you can break through the accent barrier and really start to make the language your own. Number 3, learn phrases, not just individual words. Learning grammar and individual words is great, but it's not the only approach you should take if you want to speak fluently. In addition to your regular grammar and vocabulary, try learning whole phrases, even if you aren't totally sure how they work grammatically. Learn phrases that are specific to your needs. It's a good idea to learn phrases that are grouped around a certain setting or subject, such as simple greetings or introductions, questions for getting to know someone, or traveling comfortably. You can even learn filler phrases, which you can use so that you have something to say when, well, you don't know what to say. Learning phrases like this will help you become conversational faster. You may not understand what you're saying literally, but as long as you know the general meaning behind the phrase and know when to use it, you'll be able to talk like a native. Eventually, your knowledge of grammar and vocabulary should catch up with the phrases you know. Learning a new language should feel like an adventure. There will be plateaus and periods in your learning where it feels like you're hitting a wall, but being able to speak with native speakers and have real conversations will help you combat language fatigue. After all, talking to someone face-to-face in a foreign language is one of the main reasons we start learning in the first place. And for even more ways to gain conversation skills, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hello, and welcome to this next Dutch lesson where we will talk about the must-know phrases in Dutch. My name is Stella, and I will be teaching you some very useful basic phrases in Dutch today. So let's get started. The first word of the day is hallo. Hello. Hallo. Hello. So as you can see, the standard Dutch greeting is very similar to the English one. Now, if you feel like mixing it up a little bit, you can also say hoi, which is our version of hey, and it's slightly more informal. Now, if you want to be a little less casual, for example, if you arrive at work in the morning, you could say this. Goedemorgen. Good morning. Goedemorgen. Goedemorgen. Now, if you want to be a little less casual, for example, if you arrive at work in the morning, you could say this. Goedemorgen. Goedemorgen. Good morning. You can also say this to anyone else you meet in the morning, for example, in a shop or the person you wake up next to. If it's in the afternoon, you could say this. Goedemiddag. Good afternoon. Goedemiddag. Goedemiddag. This one is much more formal than goedemorgen. In the Netherlands, you can say goedemorgen to anyone, but goedemiddag is really only used when starting a conversation with someone you don't know. For example, at the supermarket or at the beginning of a phone call. Goedenavond. Good evening. Goedenavond. Goedenavond. Good evening. This one is pretty formal. You do best to only use it, for example, when entering a restaurant or something like that. Hoe heet u? What's your name? Hoe heet u? Hoe heet u? What's your name? Bear in mind that the Dutch have a formal you, which is u, and an informal you, which is je. So if you're asking a child or a classmate what his or her name is, you should probably go with hoe heet je. Now, after learning someone's name, you'll likely be asked to say yours, to which you could say, ik ben, I'm, ik ben, enter your name here. So in my case, it would be, ik ben Stella, ik ben Stella, I'm Stella. It's just your basic introduction. After you've both stated your names, you'll likely shake hands and say something like this. Leuk je te ontmoeten. Nice to meet you. Leuk je te ontmoeten. Leuk je te ontmoeten. Nice to meet you. Now remember the difference between je and u. If you're meeting a new client at work, you may want to say leuk u te ontmoeten, just to class it up a bit. Another useful sentence right after introductions is hoe gaat het? How are you? Hoe gaat het? Hoe gaat het? How are you? It's a nice way to get to know a little bit about the other person, if they feel like sharing. Most of the time, though, they will probably just say that they're fine and leave it at that. And that would sound like this. Het gaat prima, dank je. En met jou? I'm fine, thanks. And you? Het gaat prima, dank je. En met jou? Het gaat prima, dank je. En met jou? I'm fine, thanks. And you? So when people ask you this, it's probably better not to launch into a 15-minute speech about how you are really doing. Keep it short and to the point. Now, here comes one that's rather ambiguous. Alsjeblieft. Please. Alsjeblieft. Alsjeblieft. Please. First of all, when saying this to someone you know well, say alsjeblieft. Je, u, remember? But whichever one you use, it can also mean here you go. So you say it when you're asking someone for something, but also when handing it over. It's pretty confusing, right? Crazy Dutchies. When someone hands you something, or someone has done something nice for you, the polite thing to do is say this. Dank je. Thank you. Dank je. Dank je. Thank you. And again, if you're in a formal situation, say dank u. Next one is what you say after that. Graag gedaan. You're welcome. Graag gedaan. Graag gedaan. Now this is probably a hard one because of the notorious Dutch ch sound. Just remember, if you pull this off, you'll sound very Dutch indeed. The next two are really short and to the point. Ja. Yes. Ja. Ja. Yes. Nee. No. Nee. Nee. No. Just your basic yes and no. Use them wisely. The next one is easy. You'll all recognize it immediately. Okay. 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 And of course it means okay. It's the same word and you can basically spell it any way you like, so go to town. Excuseer. Excuse me. Excuseer. Excuseer. Excuse me. You can say this if you want to pass by someone and you need them to move, for example. The second way to apologize in Dutch is Het spijt me. I'm sorry. Het spijt me. Het spijt me. I'm sorry. You can also say sorry if you've done a small thing wrong, but if you've really made a mess of things, you may want to go all the way and just go with Het spijt me. So let's move on to a few short questions. First one is, hoe laat is het? What time is it? Hoe laat is het? Hoe laat is het? What time is it? A literal translation would be, how late is it? But we use this whenever we just want to ask for the time. Waar is het toilet? Where is the restroom? Waar is het toilet? Waar is het toilet? Where is the restroom? So I'm sure you recognize the word toilet in there, but if you want to sound very Dutch, use wc for water closet. So then you would say, waar is de wc? The next one isn't a question, but a request. Wacht even. Wait a moment. Wacht even. Wacht even. Wait a moment. You can use this if someone is talking to you while you're busy, or if you need someone to not move while you grab something from a different aisle, etc. It's a very useful sentence. So if you're in a shop and you want to ask how much something is, you can ask, hoeveel kost dit? How much is this? Hoeveel kost dit? How much is this? Though usually when you're in the Netherlands, there will be clear price tags on everything. The Dutch don't haggle. If you've eaten at a restaurant and you want the check, say, mag ik de rekening alstublieft? Could I get the check, please? Mag ik de rekening alstublieft? Mag ik de rekening alstublieft? Could I get the check, please? Now remember, Dutch people will often split the bill. So if you want to ask for the check, but you don't want to necessarily imply that you'll be the one paying for it, you could say, mogen wij de rekening alstublieft? Which means, could we get the check, please? Here's a word you really need to know, but you probably already do. Help. 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 It just means help. Sometimes life will throw you a bone. Tot later. See you later. If you're taking leave of someone, you can say tot later. Tot later. See you later. You can also just say later. That's been catching on quickly lately. Here's a slightly more formal version of saying goodbye. Tot ziens. Goodbye. Tot ziens. Tot ziens. Goodbye. You're technically saying the same thing you were earlier. It just means that you'll see each other again. But this is the one you would use in a grocery store, whereas you would say tot later or later to a friend. So that's all for today. These were the must-know phrases in Dutch. If there's anything missing from this list, make sure to tell me in the comments. Like and subscribe to this channel. And if you'd like to learn more Dutch, visit DutchPod101.com. Thanks and goodbye.
Today we're going to talk about four techniques to help you stop translating in your head and instead start thinking in your target language. This will allow you to have conversations with ease, read smoothly, and better understand native speakers. These are four methods to help you think in a new language. Number one, surround yourself with your target language. This way, you'll be completely immersed in the language. Without realizing it, you'll learn pronunciation, sentence structures, grammar, and new vocabulary. Play music in the background while you're cooking, or have a radio station on while you study. Just use one of our endless podcasts available to you. These are easy to listen to in the background while doing other things. Number two, learn through observation. This is how we all learned our native languages as kids. Words will develop their own meanings that relate better to your target language, rather than meanings that are translated directly. Number three, speak out loud to yourself. Even if you're a little embarrassed, it forces you to listen to how you speak. It makes it much easier to spot simple grammar mistakes. Number four, practice daily. If you practice everything for only one day, you won't retain the information you learned. The brain can realistically only focus for about 30 minutes. So studying a little every day allows you to absorb better. Follow these steps and have patience. You'll soon be able to achieve your language learning goals. Just make sure to remember these four methods. Sign up for your free lifetime account. No credit card required, and you'll get the best free online resources. And start learning more every day. Expand your vocabulary with our Core 2000 Words ebook. It's free and packed with essential expressions that you'll use on a daily basis. Start building your vocabulary today. Click the link in the description below to download your free Dutch ebook before it's gone.